Now, it just amazes me how many people, especially in the medical profession, just treat constipation as a symptom. They do not look at the whole picture. They might just tell you it's just a lack of fiber, just take more fiber, Metamucil, whatever. And fiber will stimulate the colon, which will help you evacuate, and it's hydrating. So just take some fiber. That's it. But constipation is the effect of incomplete digestion anywhere in your digestive tract. I mean, it could be a lack of stomach acid because stomach acid helps you break down protein. If you're not breaking down protein, that can end up as undigested protein. Then you have the pancreas, which produces all these enzymes. And enzymes really work in the small intestine. You have like 20 feet of tubing called the small intestine, which, by the way, your small intestine, the little villi, actually make enzymes. And also, the pancreas releases enzymes in the small intestine, and that's where 90% of all your digestion occurs. And so if that doesn't occur correctly, guess what? Undigested food, both undigested carbohydrates, undigested fats, undigested protein, and it ends up as a constipation situation. Then you have the liver that makes bile salts, and it's stored by the gallbladder, and that's released into the small intestine. And bile salts are the detergent that helps break down fat to a certain level where the enzymes in the pancreas can then take over and fully digest the fats. But the thing about bile is bile lubricates the colon. Bile hydrates the colon. And so if you're deficient in bile, you could very easily get constipation. Now, the problem with getting too much bile is you end up with diarrhea. So you just need just the right amount, not too much, not too little. So after all this food is digested from the acid, from the enzymes, from the bile, it finally ends up into the large intestine called the colon. This is where your friendly microbes, both friendly bacteria and friendly yeast, take over, and they start to finalize this digestive process. They will take things that you can't digest, like fiber, and break those down. They also help reabsorb the water as well. And so if you have constipation, it could be that you need more stomach acid, you need bile salts, you need enzymes, or you need a good probiotic. 16% of Americans have constipation, and 30% of Americans over 60 have constipation. So it's a big deal. And I really want you to take a look at the whole digestive process if you personally have constipation, rather than just one thing like adding more fiber. And so you can get a clue on the cause of constipation and what you need to do based on when it started. So let's say it started after an antibiotic. Well, guess what? You need probiotics. And by the way, anytime you're on an antibiotic, you should automatically take probiotics at the same time. Don't wait till you're done. Take it at the same time you take antibiotics. Now, let's say, for example, you develop constipation when you took an antacid. Well, then just put back the acid. Betaine hydrochloride. Or let's say you started taking medications that have a side effect of constipation. Well, get with your doctor and find some alternative that doesn't have a side effect of constipation. Or let's say you had a history of eating a lot of cooked foods, a lot of processed foods, and no raw foods that have enzymes. Well, then start eating raw foods like raw vegetables. Or let's say there wasn't an actual time that it started, but you don't like vegetables. You don't consume a lot of vegetables. An average American consumes like a cup and a half of vegetables. Well, guess what? We need that fiber for our microbes to actually live off of. We also need the potassium and magnesium in those vegetables to help the pumping action of your colon. In fact, when you add more potassium, magnesium, that does help the bowels work correctly. And a lot of times people, instead of consuming vegetables, they might take Epsom salts, right? Which creates a laxative effect, and then they get diarrhea. Also, too many high carbohydrates can interfere with the nervous system that controls this whole process. It's called the enteric part of the autonomic nervous system. So if that's the case, you need something called benfotiamine, which is a type of B vitamin that actually will help support that issue. Also, frequent eating, it's the cramming of all this food down this pipe, never letting the body properly digest and go through its cycle. It takes 36 hours for food to be completely processed through your entire digestive tract. So if we're eating so frequently all the time, we never get a chance for your system to really clean out. Another point is stress. Stress activates the flight or fight mechanism, which inhibits the nervous system that controls the digestion, which is called the parasympathetic nervous system. So many, many times, you don't need to change the diet. You just need to fully relax. You need to improve the parasympathetic nervous system. And I put a link down below of how you should do that. Reducing your stress greatly improves your digestion. And so a couple other tips, fermented foods are good, increasing your veggies, increasing more fat, which will stimulate bile production. Because if you're on a low fat diet, that can be a reason why you don't have enough bile. And if you don't have enough bile, things dry up and you get constipation. Also lowering your carbs, I already mentioned that. And then doing intermittent fasting is very, very important. All right, thanks for watching. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.